Kyle. I own Kyle's Kinetics, and welcome to my shop. Favorite design of mine, it's called the Balancing Buoy. This design popped in my head, you know, maybe about 5 or 6 years ago. Originally, when I came up with the design, I built it using a solid steel ring like this one. And over the years, it's gone through a lot of different improvements in a lot of different stages. The reason why I'm most proud of this design is simply for the fact that it is actually really difficult to balance, and it requires no counterweights for it to balance. It in and of itself is its own counterweight. Every part of this sculpture is completely necessary. You'll notice between these two different buoys here that they're a little bit different. Notice there's no rod here on this one, but that one has it, or these brackets here. So the brackets and these bars are not only there for aesthetic, but they're also completely necessary for balancing. After I weld up these rings here, I then have to make this part right here that allows it to actually balance. From there, I can build the actual structure of the buoy upwards. The problem is that as I move it upward and as I start building it upward, the balance changes every single part that I add. If I move it up too high or too low, it completely shifts it. So as I'm building this thing up, I have to take into account the way it's balancing. So if I want it to have a really nice, slow, smooth motion, I have to strategically place metal exactly where I want it. So this top here, you see on this one, it is a solid piece of steel because I wanted more weight up as high as I could get it. Whereas on the top of this one, see how it's not all the way through, but it does have those bars there. So while these bars do act as, like I said, an aesthetic, it also allows me to shift the balance very precisely where I want it. So I can make it balance slower or faster. If there's more weight up top, I can make it move a lot slower. Do I take measurements or do I weigh anything? No, actually, I kind of eyeball absolutely everything about these designs. All the way down to this ring that's at the top here, I make everything from scratch. And these things are incredibly picky as far as the balancing goes. So when I weld this bar here in the middle that actually holds the pin that it balances on, every little thing I do will influence how it balances. So I try my absolute best to get this giant steel donut, basically. I try to get that thing to balance perfectly square the first time. And then from there, I drill a hole in the center of that of this part here, and I can put a very highly polished pin inside there. I don't know if you can see that, but I can put a little pin inside there, and then, and on this one in particular, you can kind of see a little bend on that pin. I've bent it in the direction it needs to go so that it balances straight up and down. And this whole structure here is all eyeballed. So if you look straight down it, you can actually tell that it's not perfect. Bend and twist each of the tack welds down here at these points. I just kind of bend and twist it until it makes a somewhat good looking triangle. I've probably made a couple dozen different styles of this buoy, or at least different sizes. You'll notice this one is probably the latest one that I've made that I'm going to most likely stick with. This thing's about 2 pounds, and I think it's about 8 or 9 inches tall. But again, it varies very slightly depending on the balance and how it behaves and just the small differences in where everything's welded. This big guy back here is a total of 5 pounds, and he's pretty darn heavy. When you pick it up, it's kind of surprising because the way that it balances, you don't really expect it to be that heavy because it just kind of floats there effortlessly. So this design is very much dynamic. Every single time I make it, I can use the same parts. I can pretty much measure everything out the same way every time, but it's just gonna balance a little different every single time. It's kind of like they have a life of their own. Most of my sculptures are actually kind of like that, but these ones especially, they're really difficult to balance. It's probably why they're so expensive too, because I just spend so much time getting these things to balance properly. They're really satisfying though. Once you get it right, it's really, really rewarding to see them balance properly. But that is why if you order one, yours is going to be completely unique and it's not going to be the exact same as the other ones. The other cool thing about this design is that it's larger compared to my other works, and that allows me to make some really cool effects like this here on this paint. You can see this. So what you're actually looking at are the grind marks of my grinder, and you can see them shine through this paint. This is a very special paint. And this is something that took me kind of a long time to discover. Candy 2O by Cratex. This paint is really unique. As the name suggests right there, it acts like a dye. So it doesn't coat the metal, it colors the metal so that you can still see those really cool grind marks. So whenever I'm making these things, at the very end, when it's all done, I try to make the grind marks very nice and bright and clean so that as I paint it, it makes this really cool effect. And over the years, I've not only had to teach myself metalworking, but I've also taught myself how to even paint with these HVLP spray guns. Over the years, I've gone through different stages of airbrushes and everything, and have finally decided that I love these things. They really do spray on really well. And this one actually is dedicated to spraying the clear coat on this thing, which honestly, the clear coat is the absolute reason why these things look so good. The clear coat is a two-part polyurethane that is made for cars. So this is a really, really high quality clear coat, and it's really dangerous. So I gotta wear a mask respirator every time I'm shooting this clear coat, but it creates the most beautiful effect. And I want all my work to be as high quality as possible and last for as long as possible. There have been multiple times where I've ripped off this entire structure at the top and then had to rebuild it from the ground up. I'll spend hours on it and then I have to scrap and redo it. It's just the nature of the beast with these things, just because they're so difficult. That's probably why I'm most proud of this design, just because, you know, I think I was laying in bed one night when I was trying to think of ideas, and I thought, you know, what else moves like my other balancing sculptures do? What else moves like that? And this just kind of popped in my head. But then that's where this ring came into play, and I ran out to my shop and started playing around with it. And piece by piece, I put it together, and I noticed that it started to balance, and I knew that it was gonna work. And then over the years, I've just gone up in scale on the size of the buoys. I've made a 15-pound buoy, which was, I think it was about 2 feet tall or so. You had to lift up with two hands and set it down, so that was really cool. I really like this size. It's, like I had mentioned, it's 2 pounds, and it's just a great size that it can show off the color, has just a really good presence on a desk. It doesn't take up a whole lot of space, so you can put it on the corner of any kind of desk. They're just cool. They're just kind of like this statement piece. The fact that it balances alone is kind of, it's attention grabbing, but it's also very pretty to see in person. Video just does not do these things justice one bit. You have to really see them in person. You make them bob back and forth like this, that bobbing motion lasts a whole lot longer than if you were to spin it, for example. But they can do multiple things. So you can get this thing to spin, and you can see it'll tilt on an axis. There is a lip designed into the pins of all my sculptures. So it's very safe and stable, but just be careful that it doesn't fall off. Well, I hope that provided a lot of information for you guys. It's just my little bit of humble brag about this design. If you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments. I'd love to answer them. Plus, I just wanted to show a video without it being, you know, a very dramatic or cinematic, you know, product video. I just wanted to show them in real time, in real life, what they look like. I hope you all enjoyed. Thanks for watching.